Hello and welcome to this lesson plan for the introduction to the Revit user interface. In this video, we'll cover view controls. This is video 3 of 5. My name is John Harridge and I will be your host today for this lesson. In this exercise, we will explore several ways of modifying the display and appearance of object categories in Revit. In this exercise, we will look at the following examples. Applying visibility graphic overrides to an annotation category for a specific model view, changing the detail level of a view, change view properties in general, apply a visual style to a model view, and then conclude by applying sun settings for a view for potentially a future rendering. Let's get started. Please open the Revit Intro Exercise 03 project file. A building model, even a small one, is an extensive database. There is no way to see everything in it. Views are filters through which you can see representations of the database elements in graphic or table form. View controls enable you to adjust the display of individual views to see and represent the model as you desire. First, we will practice with zooming and detail level controls in a plan view. Please right-click in the canvas window and choose Zoom to Fit. Here you can see that the elevation markers are showing. And we would like to hide those. Please enter the V key twice, Victor, Victor. We can bring up the visibility and graphics override dialog box, and we're looking for the elevations category specifically. It won't appear in the model category, so we need to move over one tab and look at the annotation categories. Go ahead and skim down until you find the elevation category and unmark it just by left clicking, and then select OK to accept and dismiss the dialog box. Next, let's perform a zoom in region command and just basically drag a window around the area of interest to enlarge it on screen. And the next thing we'll take a look at is detail levels. So it's not uncommon to cycle through detail levels at any point in time during the design cycle to just verify that you have the material finishes facing the right orientation. In this case, we changed the detail level to medium to expose walls that have multiple materials. And it may be hard to see when the lines have thickness, so I turned on the thin lines tool to help reveal the multi-materials behind the walls. Go ahead and toggle thin lines back off so it's back in its default mode. Next, let's open up the level 1 ceiling plan view. And we'll prepare the model for another type of view manipulation. Let's go ahead and zoom out. And what we want to do in this case is hide the roof element and the elevation object markers. So go ahead and place the roof in a selection set by left clicking. And then holding down the control key, window select one of the elevation markers on screen. And then again, just go ahead and key in VH, V as in Victor, H as in Help, and I'll actually hide those category objects for you. Let's go ahead and perform a zoom to fit, and then you'll see how it changes the display of that plan view. In this next exercise, we will prepare the level 2 floor plan to become the roof plan. So if you would, make the level 2 view the active view and perform a zoom to fit if necessary. And the first thing we want to do is turn off the level 1 underlay. Underlays are good when you're creating a roof, but when you're done with it, it's good to turn it off. So we can perform that task through the properties palette just by looking for the underlay property field and then selecting none and then clicking apply to actually complete that task. Next up is to modify the roof so we don't have it clipping. And we can do that by modifying what's called view range. And the view range is what controls the extents of the model in the Z-axis. So we're going to modify the cut plane to the value of 7 feet, and that's assuming that this cut plane is actually above the highest point of the roof. And when we select OK, we'll see the result, and hopefully you see the entire roof plan. Next, let's go ahead and rename the level 2 plan view, and let's call it roof, and click OK. Go ahead and zoom into the roof to get a larger view to fill the screen. Otherwise, we'll move on to the next part of the exercise, which is to prepare the south elevation view for a solar study. So in this case, let's go ahead and open up the south elevation view. And the first thing we'll do to help make the elevation more readable is we'll go ahead and enable shadows through the visual style icon in the view control bar. And there we go. I'll zoom in to make it easier to read. And then as part of that, we'll go ahead and enable shadows. And obviously you can see the shadows icon in the view control toolbar. So now we got shadows. But how do we know when those shadows are occurring in a particular part of the year? So by enabling sun settings through the sun path icon, we can actually take a look at what those assumptions are. So in this case, we want to dial this in for a specific time of year. We'll go ahead and set this up as a still study. And in addition, we'll go ahead and work with one of the existing saved profiles. We'll choose winter solstice. And last but not least, we will change the time of day to 12 p.m. Go ahead and select OK to accept and dismiss the dialog box. And that's the final result. So the shadows are longer at that particular time of year and time of day. And I'll perform an undo, which is Control Z, just to see where it started from, and then redo to see the progress that we made in this particular exercise. All right, go ahead and save the file as Revit Intro Exercise 3 finished. This concludes this exercise. Let's look at next steps. In review of this lesson, we were able to change the display for detail level, which controls how much information about the model you see on the screen. And then second, we modified the view properties to control the visibility state of a particular object category. And then last, we were able to modify the elevation view to begin looking at studying solar path studies for a particular time of year. With that, let's take a look at Autodesk Resources. I would like to make you aware of two specific Autodesk resources. The first one being the Autodesk Education Community, where you can access free software for both students and educators, and that can be located at www.students.autodesk.com. It does require registration, and you can use either your own personal email address or a school-issued email address. The second resource is the Autodesk Digital STEAM Workshop. It's hands-on, project-based learning across multiple industries such as architecture, engineering, gaming, and animation. And those resources are located at www.digitalsteam.autodesk.com. revit.com. This concludes this exercise. Thank you very much for watching.